So in this video, I'm going to show you how to build a .NET Core IoT application that runs on a Linux device. And I'm going to be using the Raspberry Pi 4 for demonstration. So this is a Hello World application that is meant to give you a foundation for you to then go on to build far much more complex .NET Core IoT applications. Okay, so here I've got my Raspberry Pi 4B device. And on GPIO pin number 4, I've got this LED connected through a resistor. And then on the other end of the LED, I've got my ground signal connected back to the Raspberry Pi. So we're going to be building an IoT application that blinks this LED. Okay, so I'm going to begin by starting up my Visual Studio 2019. And then I'll create a new project. Then I'll select a .NET Core console app and I'll call this hello.NET IoT. Okay, and then I'm going to put this in my C drive. Okay, and then I'll go ahead and click create. Okay, so my project has been successfully created. Now, since I want to control the GPIO pins of the Pi, the first thing that I want to do is to install a .NET Core IoT library package. And to do that, I'm going to right-click on my project here. Go to Manage NuGet Packages. Then I'll go to Browse. And then our .NET Core IoT library is System. .device.gpio, and then I'll install that. Click OK, accept. Okay, so my IoT library has been successfully added to the project. So I'll go back to my main C# file, and then I'll add the library to my assembly reference here. Okay, so when our application first runs, we want to print out hello world. This is a .NET Core IoT app. Now I've got my LED connected to GPIO pin number 4. So I'll declare the pin. And then I'll instantiate a GPIO controller to control the input-output pin. And then I'll set the pin. As an output pin, since we're going to be writing to it. And then here I'll create a super loop. And then here I'll switch on the LED by sending a high signal to the GPIO pin. And then I'll delay for 1 second. And then I'll switch off the LED by writing a low to the GPIO pin. And then I'll also delay 1 second after that. Okay, so that's all we need to do as far as the code for blinking the LED is concerned. Okay, so now we need to package our app in a self-contained environment that would allow us to run it in a Linux device such as the Raspberry Pi 4. Now to do that, we go to our project here, right-click, select publish. So we're going to publish to a folder, and then we can leave the folder path as default. Create profile, and then on the target framework, we select the edit icon. And then here under deployment mode, you select self-contained, and then the target runtime, you select the Linux ARM, which is the architecture for the Raspberry Pi. And then we click on save. And then I'll go ahead and publish this. Okay, so the app has been successfully published. Now take note of the target location. So I'll go to my C drive here. And then if I go to hello.net IoT, bin, release,
And then inside my publish folder, these are all the files for our app, the ones that we're going to be transferring to our Raspberry Pi. Now, the next thing that you need to do is to download the WinSCP application, which is a utility that gives us access to the Raspberry Pi terminal and allows us to transfer files to it. And you can do that by going to the winscp.net website. So I've already downloaded this application, so I'll go ahead and open it. Now, first of all, make sure that you've installed the official Raspberry Pi operating system and you have enabled secure shell access. Now, here under file protocol, we select SCP, and then I'll enter the IP address of my Raspberry Pi. I'll enter the username and my password, and then I'll click on login. Okay, now before I transfer my app files onto the Raspberry Pi and start running it, I need to make sure that the dependencies that are required for us to run a .NET Core application on the Raspberry Pi are installed. Now, I could have used this terminal right here on this WinSCP utility, but as you can see, this has got limitations, especially with commands that involve data transfer. So to do that, I'm going to use PuTTY instead. And then I'll log in. Okay, and then we need to execute this instruction here to install the dependencies. Okay, now we can go ahead and transfer our files onto the Raspberry Pi. Now, what you're looking at on the right of this utility is the Raspberry Pi directories, and then on the left is my Windows PC. Now, I'm going to create a new directory here under the Pi directory, and then I'll call this hello.net IoT, and then I'll click OK. And then I'll open the directory. And then move all the files onto the Raspberry Pi. Okay, now by default, the Linux operating system won't allow our executable to run, so we have to give it the permission. And to do that, we right click on our executable, go to properties, and then make sure this X is checked. So I'll just check everything and then I'll click on OK. Okay, so we've successfully created and published our .NET Core IoT app, and we've also transferred the files onto our Raspberry Pi. Now let's go ahead and run our IoT application. And to do that, I'm going to use PuTTY to access the Raspberry Pi terminal. And then I'm going to go into my hello.net IoT directory. And then I'm going to run my IoT app. So as you can see, we've got our message to show that our app is running. And if you check there, our LED is blinking. So if you found this video useful, please press the like button and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more IoT videos like this as they come out.